Mr. Mayor, surprisingly and welcomingly, all our neighbouring authorities have student committees to look at children's services and adult services separately. It's clear that those authorities believe in and embrace scrutiny. Mr. Mayor, even if you use the four figures in the Cabinet's desktop research, it shows that the comparable authorities have an average of between 4 and 5 scrutiny committees. And if you use the correct figures, it's between 5 and 6 scrutiny committees. So how Wirral comes up with 3 is a real mystery. It's like a figure the Cabinet member has pulled from the sky. Mr. Mayor, given the clear and evident flaws in the methodology, it really is incumbent on Council, of course, to seek professional advice, to come up with a strong, effective set of scrutiny arrangements. And Mr. Mayor, listen to the LGA peer review and offer opposition members a leadership role on the scrutiny committees. Mr. Mayor, it's for all those reasons that I ask Council to support the Conservative objection. Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Opportunity our members with those valuable skills could use them for the benefit of the community. scrutiny committees are widely perceived, probably within the council and certainly externally, to be biased in favour of the ruling administration. There now also appears to be an attempt by Cabinet to limit the number and type of executive decisions that can be scrutinised. This is unacceptable, opaque, undemocratic, and can cause frustration and resentment and anger. In parallel with this, to have scrutiny carried out by a committee chaired and dominated by those in the ruling group is as immoral as it is divisive and actually laughably stupid. I'm always happy to go along with the principle of fair election resulting in executive decisions being made by one political party taking overall control of council or parliament. That is democracy. But to deliberately and cynically prevent the proper constructive unbiased scrutiny of all executive functions is against normal justice and advice and is totally wrong, irrespective of whether it is technically legal or not. We recently witnessed appalling maladministration and grossly biased and incompetent investigations of actions and cover-ups perpetrated by the police elsewhere in the country, with other recent paedophile investigations around the country, to name but a few. I am certainly not...
Working group and panels, they may or may not be held in public. points have been already outlined greatly in what is lacking in the report and what is before us as a council. The first comment I would like to make is the comment that the council member says, in their opening remarks, it's a 25% cut in the budget, which is a saving, and I understand that, because the situation council is and the country is financially. But that again relates to a quarter less scrutiny being taken, because that's the percentage that an obvious result of that. We can see the amount of work that needs to be done to make sure that we are run in an efficient and clear and openly way. We've moved the notice of motion that we've got, it's in relation to the city region right down to what we do ourselves, because we do not know what the city region's going to do, we don't know the scrutiny. Three meetings we've had now with the select committee dialogue, and it's a verbal report from one of the members who sits on it in this council. And the majority of it is, we don't know what's happening, we just carry on. And that's no way to run an authority in any way or any form. I'd like to, when I deputise with my leader for the government, on one of the constitution review council meetings, well, I think it was in relation to notice of motions and the ability to put one forward to local council. I pick up the point that was raised earlier on, where the way the review was done and been held. I received a file like this, and I read through it, and I did read through it. Those members that were there at that meeting will understand how hard it was, because I picked out the amount of authorities that actually had two members of the council that brought a notice of motion forward, and most of them were our neighbours. But this council wants to have at least five. Really, preventing small parties, mine is not the largest party here, we are the second largest on Merseyside, but, you know, we have the opportunity to make sure that there's nothing funny about Mr. Mayor, it's just the truth.
Can we let Councillor Mitchell carry on, please? I'll give you an extra minute of this.
Discussion about future.
Please let the lead off the council speak.
So if this presages a new environment in which the opposition are going to take their responsibilities constructively, then I welcome that, but I think the jury's out. We need to wait and see. But I would just point out, because members of the party opposite have chair and various scrutiny panels, Councillor Clements, you have, Councillor Sykes, you have. So to say that we're not giving way at all, I think is being disingenuous. The reality is, Mr. Mayor, this is a sensible change. I kind of think the other point I wanted to make in response to Councillor Gilchrist's amendment, all of the issues that Councillor Gilchrist is saying we need to, the scrutiny committees need to look at, devolution, children's services, they can do that. They can do that when they sit down and work out a work programme at the start of the year. There's nothing to stop the scrutiny members devising a work programme which includes all of those topics that you want to look into in more detail on their work programme. It's in your hands. It's not for me, as a member of the cabinet, to decide what's on the work programme. You have the power in your hands. So I do believe, in conclusion, Mr. Mayor, that this is a minor adjustment. It will not shackle in any way the democratic rights of members to hold the executive to account. I think this is a sensible, modest change that aligns scrutiny with the Wirral Council plan, which we've all agreed. To delay this now, I think, would be a mistake. We can evaluate it, we can look at good practice elsewhere, but for goodness sake, let's just get on with this and let's make scrutiny work. Thank you, Mr. Mayor. To participate and take part in those committees, Mr. Mayor.
Roberts.
Against.
Councillor Rowlands.
For.
Councillor Tony Smith.
Against.
Councillor Walter Smith.
Against.
Councillor Spriggs.
Against.
Councillor Stapleton.
Against.
Councillor Stewart.
Against.
Councillor Sullivan.
Against.
Councillor Sykes.
For.
Councillor Usher.
Against.
Councillor Walsh.
Against.
Councillor Ward.
Against.
Councillor Hobbs.
For.
Councillor Ivan Williams. Councillor Jeremy Williams.
Against.
Councillor Steve Williams.
For.
Councillor Williamson.
Against.
Okay, the result of that amendment was 4, 23, against 37, and abstention 1, so that's lost. Okay, on to the next amendment, moved by Councillor Gilchrist.
All those in favour?
Against.
That's a vote.